आईएससी स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हैप्पी इंडिपेंडेंस टू ईच वन ऑफ यू। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डू द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज 2C विच इज बेस्ड ऑन द टॉपिक functions. I remember in the last video I did the questions up to 6. So today I will finish the exercise 2C, and if I get the time I'll do the questions of 2D. This video is for ISC students of ICSC board. Question number 6. Sorry, 6 up to 5 we did. I start with question 5. Up to 4 I did in the last video. Question 5. Which of the 4 statements given below is different from the others? We have 4 statements. First one, second, third, F is a mapping of A into B. 4, F is a function of A into B. F is a function of A into B. So we have 4 statements. We have to select the odd one out. I would like to tell you, all these 4 statements are indicating that we have a function from set A to set B. This one seems to be odd one, but it is not actually odd. All these are indicating the same. I mean a function from set A to set B. So no one in this is odd one out, means all the 4 are same. Here x belongs to set A and this fx belongs to set B. So all the 4 statements are same. Next one, question number 6. Let us get the answer for this question. What we have? We have a set A with its elements -2, -1, 1, 2, and a function F such that it is collection of the elements x comma 1 by x, where x belongs to set A. What we have to do? First part. Actually, I would not say that this is a function, I would say this is a relation. because the fourth part, sorry, third part of the question is this a function? So I am not considering this one as a function, I am considering this one as a statement or as a relation. So a relation becomes function only when, if every element of set A is mapped with an element of set B. If one element do not have two images, I mean if there is a such type of relation in which we see that one element of A is connected with two elements of B, so that relation will not convert to function. So first part of the question is, find, list the domain of this relation F. So domain is the collection of X. Domain is the collection of X. So if, first of all, before answering the first part, I would like to write every element of this relation F, minus 2, its image will be minus 1 upon 2 or 1 upon minus 2. X, when X is the first component, so second component of the element of this relation will be reciprocal of first component. Second one, minus 1, its reciprocal is 1 upon minus 1. Third element of this relation is 1, 1, 2, 1 upon 2. So I see that in this relation we get 4 elements. Now, first part, domain, collection of first component, minus 2, minus 1, 1, 2. Second, range of this relation, range, second component, collection of second component, a set of collection of second component, minus 1 by 2, minus 1, 1, 1 by 2. Okay. Now, the third part, is this relation a function? As I told you, if you see that every element of A, I mean every element of A has its image in B. So minus 2 has its image minus 1 by 2, minus 1 has its image minus 1, 1 has its image 1, 2 has its image 2. So this one belongs to another set. So collection of second component is called range, collection of first component is the domain. Every domain, element in every domain has its image in codomain, therefore we can say that this relation is function also. Yes, it is function. If you see that minus 2 or minus 1 or 1 or 2 got connected with two elements, then that relation will never be function. If you see that an element of A does not have its image, then in that case also this set will not be called, this relation will not be called function. Question number 7 now. But here I have this relation is function. So I have written all the parts. You can note it down. Now question 7. We have a function from x to highest prime factor of x. First part, find the range of f if the domain is Let's write. Very easy. So this is, this element belongs to domain. So you can say that this is the first component of an element belonging to the relation, belonging to the function f. So for this first component 12, the corresponding second component will be its highest prime factor. It's written here. For x, the range is its highest common factor. So if x is 12, you know that x belongs to domain and y belongs to codomain. So if x is 12, so corresponding y or corresponding range for 12 will be, corresponding component for 12 will be its highest prime factor. So when you factorize 12, you will get its factor as 2 and 3. Prime factors, I am saying, 2 and 3. So the highest one out of 2 and 3 is 3. Come to 13. 13 has got its highest prime factor as 13 itself, while 14 has got its highest prime factor as 7. 15, its two different prime factors are 3 and 5. So 5 is the highest one. For 16, it has got only one prime factor, and that is 2. So 2 is the highest prime factor for 16. 17. 17 is a prime number, so its highest prime factor is 17 itself. So collection of these elements will be called, will be considered as the range of the function f. Now next, second part, state a domain of 5 integers in the second part. State the domain of 5 integers for which the range is only 3. So range has only one element in it, and that is 3. So this is 3. So corresponding x we have to find. So we have to find all those 5 integers which have their highest prime factor as 3. So you start writing. Please see the first one, 2 into 3, 6. 6 has got its highest prime factor 3. 2 into 2 into 3, 12. 12 has got its highest prime factor as 3. So start writing the domain. First you can write it as 6. Second you can write as 12. 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, 24. You can write next one as 3 into 3. Even 9 you can write. 9 is a number which has got its highest prime factor as 3. Another one, 3 into 3 into 3, 27. So many numbers you can write, but since we have to select only the 5 integers, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12, 24, 9 and 27, these are the elements of the domain, such that each element of this domain has got its highest prime factor, not more than 3. Next, state a domain a set of 5 integers is called S. Shown by the symbol S. What can be said about these integers if given Fs equals to S? We have to give the special name to the set of 5 integers such that Fs equals to S. Fs equals to X means, please see here, S belongs to domain. Fs is the collection of range which belongs to codomain. Okay, so it's given that Fs equals to S means when you write an integer, its image, which is the highest prime factor of that integer, is this integer itself, and that is possible only when this number is prime. As you can see, for 13, the image is 13 itself. For 17, the image is 17 itself. So, Fs is equal to S, or S equals to Fs is possible only when you take here prime numbers. So, this S will be the collection of prime numbers.
So, answer will be collection of prime numbers.
Next, question number 8. What is that?
We have
x greater than 3 and fx is equal to 3x minus 2. The range for x is greater than or equal to minus 2, but less than or equal to 2. In this case, when x is greater than 2, fx equals to 3x minus 2. And when x is greater than or equal to minus 2, but less than 2, the fx is x square minus 2. We have two functions.
Find f0 plus f4.
Very simple question. So, the value of x is 0 here. So, we need to think x belongs to this inequation or this inequation.
this inequation says that the value of x is more than 3. So f 0, this x which is 0 will not belong to this inequation. Therefore, the value of f 0 will not be calculated by this formula. X is greater than or equal to minus 2 but less than or equal to 2. So in between these two numbers, 0 will lie. So the value of f 0 we will get by this function fx. Understood? F 0 we can calculate, the numerical value of f 0 we can calculate using this one. While f 4 which is more than 3, this 4 is more than 3, we can calculate the value of f 4 using this formula. At the place of x you put 4, you will get f 4. At the place of x you put 0, you will get f 0. Add them, you will get the answer. So f 0 we will get from this, because 0 belongs to this range, not this. So how do we get f 0? With this 0 square minus 2 plus f 4. F 4 we will get from the first function, 3 into 4 minus 2. So minus 2 plus 12 minus 2, 10. So 10 minus 2, 8. Answer. Second part, we have a function from R to R, real number to real number. We have a function from R to R such that it has got dual nature, such that, sorry, not dual, triple. It will be 4x minus 1 or x square minus 2 or 3x plus 4. For different ranges of x, when x is more than 4, fx will be 4x minus 1. When x is in between minus 2 to 4, fx will be x square minus 2. And when x is less than minus 2, it will be 3x plus 4. What we have to calculate? We have to calculate f5 plus f 0 plus f minus 5, f 5, f 0, f minus 5. So this f 5, 5 is an integer, this is value of x. So 5 is an integer which will come to this range. X is more than 5, so the value of x is 5 here. So fx, this will be used. So to calculate f5, this one will be used. So we will write here 4 into 5 minus 1. So this is the value of f5 which we have got with this, plus f0. 0 will belong to this range. So f0 will come with this formula, 0 square minus 2 plus f minus 5. Minus 5 will be in this range, less than minus 2. So f minus 5 we will get with this. So 3 into minus 5 plus 4. So 4, 5 is 20 minus 1, 19. This is minus 2. Minus 15 plus 4, minus 11. So 19 minus 13, 6. Next, question number 9. What we have in this question? What is the fundamental difference between a function and a relation? Every function is relation, but every relation is not function. Second thing,
one element of codomain cannot have two images, while it can happen in case of relation. Second part of the question, we have two sets X 1 2 3 4, Y 1 5 9 11, two sets X and Y we have. Determine which of the following sets are relation. Second, function. Third, neither. F1 collection of X comma Y such that Y is the square of X. As usual, X belongs to set X, small y belongs to set Y. Every element of, if we want to have a function from X to Y, if we want to have a function from X to Y, listen to me, every element of X must have its image in Y. So 1, when I take X equals to 1, I will get Y as 1. Do we have 1 here? Yes. When I take 2, do we have 4 here? This is question number 9. Listen, if I take the value of X as 2, the corresponding Y will be 4. Do we have 4 in this Y? No. So since this 2 has its image 4, which does not belong to codomain Y, therefore, how can this relation be function? Now, we have to see whether it is a relation or not. For that, very simple way. Using this, I draw a diagram. Please see. I write here X. I don't write here X. I write here X and here Fx. Okay? So, if you take 1, no, its image will be 1. Do we have 1? So, 1 is connected with 1. Okay? Now, 2, when you write here 2, will you get the image of 2 in this Y? No. Now, 3, yes, 3 is connected with 9. 4, 4 is connected with 16. So, what we see? We see that 4 is connected with 16, which belongs to Y, 1 is connected with 1, which belongs to Y, 3 is connected with 9, which belongs to Y, but this 2 is not connected with, so this relation, this cannot be a function. Now, for second one is, first one is relation, let's check the relation. For relation, what do we need? For relation, we need x and y. Now, so in this we get the elements of this as 4, 16, 1, 1, 3, 9. Yes, this is a relation. But this relation cannot be function, because I see that the domain has got 4 elements. This 2 does not have image in Y. That's why this relation cannot be a function. Second part. Second is, let me write set X and Y again. One, two, three, four. While Y has 1, 5, 9, 11, 15, 16. The function is the relation is defined by the order. We have the collection of order pair in F2 as 1, 1. This is collection of order pair. We have to check whether this collection of order pair is relation or not, function or not, or nothing. 1, 1, 2, 11, 3, 1. 4, 15. So this collection of order pair has got 1, 2, 3, 4 elements in it. Okay, let us check whether this is a relation or not. Then we will go for function. Then we will go for neither. So 1 has got its image 1. Okay, 2 has got its image 11, which belongs to Y. 3 has its got image 1. No, this 4 has got its image 15. So first component 1, 2, 3, 4 are belonging to X. Second component 1, 11, 1, 15. 1, 11, 1, 15 belonging to Y. So for a relation, what criteria is used? Relation is the collection of ordered pairs X, Y such that X belongs to the first set and Y belongs to the second set. So first component 1, 2, 3, 4 belonging to X. Second component 1, 11, 1, 15, 1, 11, 1, 15 belonging to Y. So this is relation. But whether it is function or not, the first condition, every 1, 2, 3, 4, every first component should be the domain, should be the collection of the set of domain. So 1, 2, 3, 4, we have 4 elements in this X, we have 4 elements in the collection of the first component, correct? Second thing, if every element of the first, every first component has its image in the codomain, correct? 1 has its image 1 in this, 2 has its image 11 in this, 3 has its 11 image 1 in this, 4 has its image 15 in this. Now the one confusion is for you, sir. 1 has image 1, 3 also 1. Will this relation remain function, be function or not? I said one element of domain should not have 2 images. I did not say that 2 elements of domain cannot have 1 image. 2 elements of domain can have 1 image in domain, codomain. I am saying that, please see, if you don't understand, this type of relation can be function, but this type of relation means one with many, that relation will not be function. Many with one, that relation can be a function. Suppose I have an element here in set X, and that element is not having image in codomain. In that case also the relation will not be becoming the function. Remember it. So this relation is function also. Yes. Yes. While in first case it was only relation, not the function. So you can write it is function. You can write it is function, and every function is relation, you know it. So if you write it is a function, this answer will be included in that answer itself. So if you don't write this, it will not be considered as the wrong answer. It is correct. Yes, it is function. It does not mean it is not relation. Every function is relation, keep it in mind. So this is collection of relation and function both, or this collection is collection of ordered pairs which can be considered as relation as well function both. Third one, what we have in third, we have 1, 5, a set of collection of ordered pairs 1, 5, 2, 9, 3, 1, 4, 5, 2, 11. So this set has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ordered pairs. Let us see whether all these ordered pairs together forming a relation or not, forming a function or not, or it is neither relation nor function. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 2. It is not a function. 2 is coming 2 times. So when the first component is repeated, I mean when first component, you see, 2 is connected with 9, 2 is connected with element. So how can it be function? It cannot be a function. Now let's check whether it is relation or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2. First component must be the part of X. Go to the second component. 5, 9, 1, 5, 11. 5, 9, 1. Second component is 5. Yes, it is. It is relation. Check it. Y has got 1, 5, 9, 11, 15, 16. This X has got 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 is connected with 5, 2 is connected with 9, 3 is connected with 1, 4 is connected with 5, and 2 is connected with 11. So this 2 is connected with 2 images. 2 is having 2 images, so it cannot be function. But it is relation. It is a relation. Yes, it is relation. So you, yes, relation. Now next one, it is relation from X to Y. Next, last one, we have collection of ordered pairs 1, 7, 3, 5, 1, 2, 3. So second component 2, 7, 5. Do we have 7 in this Y? Do we have 7? No. So how this order, collection of ordered pair is relation? This collection of ordered pair is not relation even, so how can it be function? I am saying that 1 has got its image 1. 2 has got its image 7, but do we have 7 in Y? No, we don't have 7 in Y. Therefore, this collection of ordered pair is neither relation, and if it is not relation, it cannot be function also. So you will be writing here neither. Means neither relation nor function. Now question number 10. What we have in this? A certain jet plane has an average speed of 500 km per hour. It can carry sufficient fuel for a 5-hour flight. Define a relation as a set between the distance d and time t for this plane. Distance d and time t. Distance d and time t. Very simple. Very simple. D comma t, where distance is equal to 500 t. Range for t is less than or equal to 5, less than or equal to 5. Next, what we have? Define the relation as a set between the distance d. Okay. Next is, state the domain of the relation. Domain. So since the time is 5 hours, so domain will be 5 into 5, 25. Less than r equal to 2500. No. So domain will be the collection of distance which will be more than 0 but less than r equal to 500. Next is, state the range of this relation. Range, this is range. Collection of t which is less than or equal to 5. Next, is this relation a function? The question is this relation a function? Yes, it is a function, because when we put the different value of t, we will get the different value of d. A relation cannot be turned to function if for one distance there are two timings. One distance, two timings. Is it possible? If it is possible, then this relation cannot be function. Yes, it is function. Question number 11 now. The answer of this is not matching with the answer what I have got. Next is, state the question number 11. The domain of a function is the set of positive integers less than 12. domain is 1, 2, 3 less than 12.
Y is equal to fx is equal to mod x minus 4. Find all ordered pairs satisfying the function, graph the function.
Let us write all the ordered pairs. When we put the value of x,
let me go through. Less than 12 written, domain of a function set of positive integers.
Less than 12, so it cannot be 12. So put here 11, 11 minus 4, 7. Put here 10, 10 minus 4, 6. 9 minus 4, 5. 8 minus 4, 6 minus 4, 7 minus 4, 6 minus 4. Give the different values. 6 minus 4, 5 minus 4, 4 minus 4, 3 minus 4. 3 minus 4 will be minus 1, but since this is mod, so result will be plus 1, which I have written here.
So 7654321 0. 7654321 0. That will be what we have to find. The domain. Find the order pair satisfying the function. Graph the.
So let me write. 7. We have got when we put 11. 11 comma 7. Correct. Then 10 comma 6. 9 comma 5, 4, 8 comma 4, 7 comma 3, 6 comma 2, 5 comma 1, 4 comma 0, 3 comma 1, 2 comma 2. And when you give 1, 1, 3, put the value of 1 here, you will get 1 minus 4 minus 3, but since this is mod, so for 1 the image will be 3, 1, 3. These many elements will be there in that function. Graph the function. I hope you know how to graph the function. You have to mark here first component 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 11. And here the range is, maximum range is 7. This is range, okay? And this is domain. So you mark here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You mark here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 11 comma 7, 11 comma 7, 10 comma 6, 9 comma 5, 8 comma 4, 7 comma 3, 6 comma 2, 5 comma 1, 4 comma 0, 3 comma 1, 2 comma 2,
1 comma 3.
I have written here.
Do we have 1 comma 3? Graph the domain of function. The domain of function is a set of positive integers. Find all the ordered pairs satisfying the function. Graph the function. 1 comma 3. Okay, we have got how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
So we have got grabbed. Now the last question, question number 12. X equals to 2, 3. So X has got two elements. So cardinal number of X is 2. Y has got three elements. Cardinal number of Y is 3.
Cardinal number of Y is 3. How many different functions are there from X to Y?
From X to Y. 2.
We have to find the different functions from X into Y.
(3)² (9).
So, my dear students, the remaining questions, I could not do the questions of exercise 2D. So that I will do in the next video. In case you have any doubt, you can write it in the comment box. I'll try my level best to clear your doubts. Bye bye. See you. Meet you in the next video. Once again, happy Independence Day. Enjoy the day. And I hope you know that school is reopening. So go to school and enjoy the offline teaching made by the teachers. Bye bye.